So for the last video, we've replicated combustion to adjust the behavior of the stars. For this episode, we'll be making tail portion of these stars. We'll start off by making some space after the set position. This instance on points is taking too much space, so I'll Ctrl H to minimize it. Next, let's add another simulation zone. Multiple simulation zones can be used in parallel, but make sure you do not connect them serially into simulation input. This will cause simulation zone on the left to stop its calculation after first frame. So add join geometry and connect from side like so. Just be aware that there are two positions in the socket you can connect to. Make sure you connect to the top. Next, let's add another join geometry and connect the result of simulation zone like so. Let's check out the animation. So it looks like nothing has changed, but by zooming in, you can see there are multiple points being spawned. These represent the point position of previous frames, leaving its tracks. If you add points to curve node here, you can connect all these points and make it into a spline. The curve trail left is kind of close to the tail we want. However, if we let the animation run through, you'll end up with these funky patterns. It looks cool, but we'll have to fix this. So two things we want to fix. First, we want to make sure that tail is cut to certain lengths and disappears with time. Second is that funky pattern. So let's start with the tail lengths. Let's hop into the init shell node group and add a new attribute. Call it tail lifetime. Connect it to group input and rename it to tail lifetime. We'll just input 1 second for both shell and the star. Next, we'll go back to where we make the tail, add a store named attribute, and bring it down. We'll call this attribute tTailSpawn, then duplicate. Call this tTailKill. Plug in SceneTime to tTailSpawn. Then add scene time with named attribute tail lifetime and connect it to tTailKill. To be exact, these are not the lifetime of the tail itself, but that of points that make up the tail. Next, add a delete geometry node. Pull out a greater than from selection socket. Change the type to float. Set a conditional so points get deleted once scene time exceeds tTailKill. When we run the animation, we can observe the tail curve gets trimmed each frame. On to fixing this pattern. So the reason this happens is because points to curve is just connecting all the points based on its index. It's not making any kind of distinctions. However, this node has input socket of curve group ID and can generate multiple curves based on that input. So all we have to do is assign unique IDs to each shell and stars. let's hop back to init shell and add store named attribute. Change type to integer and call it shell ID. Pull out a group input and rename it to shell ID as well. The first init shell null group is for the launch shell, so let's set its ID to 0. Init shell within simulation zone requires a bit of calculation. First, branch out an attribute statistics from geometry socket. Using the shell ID named attribute we just made, connect it up to attribute. Next, add 1 to max, then add index. Plug it into shell ID input. Lastly, connect the named attribute shell ID to curve group ID socket of points to curve. Let's run the animation and see the result. The tail portion is divided up nicely. Let's check the shell ID on spreadsheet. First shell is set to 0, and stars have numbers allocated in order. Seems like they have unique IDs. Let's group these nodes up and call it calc shell ID. Just for additional verification, let's set this isShell to true. This will cause points to burst multiple times, but we can check if the unique ID still holds. Okay, seems like they're working correctly, so let's uncheck the checkbox. Next, let's move on to tail movement. Tail of fireworks should wiggle a bit, and should not be this straight, so I'm going to be adding some noise. Before adding a noise though, I'm going to be adding an attribute we will be using over and over. Add a store named attribute after points to curve. Call it fac tail life. Think of it as a normalized age of each point. Connect map range from value and drive it with scene time. Connect the named attribute ttail spawn to from min and connect ttail kill to from max. Keep 2min and 2max as it is. Group these nodes up and call it calc fac tail life. If we connect this to a viewer, we can see that the young points closer to head has a low value, and old points at tip of the tail has high values. Okay, let's move on to the noise itself. First, prepare a set position. Add a noise texture. Then change the noise scale to 0.1. Set the detail and lecinarity to 0 and pull out a vector mask from color socket. Change the calculation to subtract and subtract 0.5 to center the noise to 000. Next, add a vector mask scale and scale it by 10. Lastly, add another vector mask scale and plug in the result to set position offset. If we run the animation, we get some noise on the tail. I want the noise to have less effect at the top, so let's plug in that fact tail life to scale. Now it's less squiggly at the top. Alright, let's restart the animation. It looks like tadpoles. Okay, let's group them up and call it calc tail noise. We're done for this video, so let's summarize. We added quite a few nodes today. First, two additional attributes in init shell. This is inside calc shell ID. This part forms a tail. Inside calc fact tail life. And this is inside calc tail noise. In the next video, we will be applying mesh on top of curve and make spark shader. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.